The temptations are so great in these Western countries in the name of freedom. I know that it's hard. You must isolate yourself strenuously. Of course, to live in the West is completely different from living in Egypt or in any Orthodox country. Why? Because when you live in an Orthodox country in Egypt or in Greece or in Russia or in Syria or wherever, you are living in a world, in a milieu, in a social setting that accepts the truth of God, God's truth, the truth of the Bible, the truth of the liturgy, the truth of all the Orthodox tradition. When you live in the West, you live in a society which does not accept that truth. The greater number of the people around you don't believe all the things that you believe, and they actually think that you are foolish for believing them. So, not only do you have the internal warfare, which everyone has. Every Christian is under sentence of war from Satan. But when you live in a Christian community, in our case, an Orthodox Christian community, you have help. You have the help of all the world around you, the cradle. You are living in the cradle of Christianity. It's protecting you. You can't fall out of the cradle. You might cry, you might wake up and cry, but you are still in the cradle. But when you live in the West, in a Western country, in America or in England or in Australia or France or Germany or Italy, whenever you live in any of these countries, you are living in a world where that cradle has been long since broken and the baby is fallen down. So you are living where people do not know, do not believe, do not want to know, do not want to believe in all the things that you know and believe. And they think you are foolish. They attack you. The temptations are so great in these Western countries in the name of freedom. Okay? In the West, you are free to have sex without marriage. You are free to take stimulants, to take alcohol, to take tobacco, to take hallucinatory drugs. You are free to do anything you like. You are free even to be without God. You are free to live for yourself. You can worship money, you can worship success, you can worship whatever you like. No one will blame you. It's natural. It's considered normal. So I understand the struggle that you have a huge difference between, that there is a huge difference between living in the cradle of Christianity, Coptic Christianity in our case, or living thrown out of the cradle, completely thrown on the floor and rolling around on your own. It's hard to regard as a temptation and a sin what is regarded by others and by your close friends as completely normal behavior. So why should you refuse premarital sex when everybody is having it? Why should you refuse to smoke marijuana when it's considered perfectly normal? Why should you refuse to eat a hamburger on Wednesday and Friday? I want to suggest that there is only one way to succeed. It's only exceptional people who can stand in a fire and not feel that they are burnt. Okay, this is... Many times I have seen spiritual writers say, well, you don't need to be a monk in a monastery, you can be a monk in the world. People who say that have never tried it, right? You can't. You cannot replicate the protection of the womb, the protection of the mother's womb after birth. You are outside, halas. Why do we have a process of weaning? Because the human being must be taken away from its mother's breast to live by itself. You cannot live in the same condition when you are an adult in a Western country as when you are a child in Sunday school in Egypt. I know it's not possible. So I suggest, my advice to the youth, to the Coptic youth, is that you must isolate yourself strenuously. Now, St. Paul says, be separate. All through the Old Testament, one of the lessons we can take from the Old Testament is that God set his people apart. Why was Ezra so annoyed? Why was he so angry with the people? Because they took foreign wives. In this case, foreign means not believing, right? If you want with all your heart to remain in your Coptic Orthodox world, if you want to remain close to God, if you want to be hand in hand, to walk hand in hand with Jesus, you must isolate yourself, you must protect yourself. Do not be ashamed of it, do not be weak about it. You must say to yourself, for a higher good, I will suffer this loss of freedom. And you do it every day. For example, you want to pass your exams to be a doctor, or to be a lawyer, or to be an accountant, or to be a vet, or to be a teacher, or to be a mechanic. Right? Whatever you want to do, you have to finish your apprenticeship, pass your exams, serve your probationary period, and become a professional. And you give up many things for that. Don't say it's a sign of weakness. It's not. It's a sign of strength, that you are applying your mind to your situation. No animal will put himself in another enemy territory if he can get food in his own territory. This is a natural wisdom. So why do you put yourself in the fire when you know that you will get burned? If you stay with your family, with your Coptic friends, with your father, your priest, and you are satisfied, and you are happy, if you do that, you will keep your innocence. If you don't, you will lose it. What do you want? You want to lose it? You want to taste that? You want to be like Eve? You want to taste the bitter fruit? Okay, taste it. But you will die. Huh? So, you look at Eve and Mary. You know the difference between Eve and Mary, right? Now you have to decide. You have a free choice. God never said, I will force you. He never will force you. You can choose to be Eve or you can choose to be Mary. But you have to serve somebody. It might be God or it might be the devil, but you have to serve someone. So my advice is, isolation is protection. Keep your world simple, keep your world small. And you do not pretend that you can dress sexily and not be regarded with lust. Do not pretend that you can smoke intoxicants and not be addicted. Do not pretend that you can shoplift and not be caught. Do not pretend that you can indulge in any of the so-called vices of the Western world and not become damaged by them. You will be damaged.